course, being involved in the music industry, there's so much corruption in this music industry, and there's so many things that happen behind the scenes that is very wild when it actually comes to light. And this is why you have people like Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyyah, one of the scholars of the past. He said that music is the Quran of the devil. And this is why you see that most of the people that come from the music industry, in fact, they actually do some of the worst sins, and they actually become some of the worst people that ever walked the face of this earth, from starting off with good manners. But once they enter to the music industry, I seen it personally and witnessed it, they always turn to another person that they didn't even expect. And yes, I know some people personally, I won't mention their name, and we asked a lot of guidance to Islam. It's a very, very famous rap group that sold maybe 30, 40 million records worldwide. They used to actually be engagement and talking to devils, jinns, and worshiping the shaitan. And they told me stories how they used to be aided by the shayateen, and it was aided by the jinns and aided by the devils. So you have a corruption that happens in the music industry that's is very different than any other entertainment. And this is why you see some of them always have some bad endings if Allah don't guide them. And I'm gonna end it with a story about your question that happened when I first accepted the religion of Islam. It was a lady. She was friends of my cousins and the wife of my cousin. And when my cousin accepted Islam and his wife accepted Islam, she came to the house and she said that I practice every religion except for Islam. This is a woman who never heard of jinns. This is a woman who never heard of the unseen. She said that she used to be in conversation with the jinns, the devils, the ghosts that some people might call it. And she said to the point that the jinn would come carry her, and she would be able to see certain things that her friends was doing, and she would call her friends, and she would tell them about, I seen you do this last night, and they would be very shocked. And she said, when the jinn came to us, and we hear these stories from Islam, that they would come and they would give you pieces, they would break you off slowly but surely, and they pretend that they will help you and they will aid you, but eventually they want you to do some immoral things. She said, at the end, the shaitan or the jinn who was helping her came to her and said, we need you to have one more thing. When you do this last thing, we're going to put you on a whole nother level, for example. And just to mention what she said, not to go into details, they asked her to do something that was very, very immoral. And she said ever since that day, she walked away and she stopped dealing with this religion because of the thing that it asked her to do at the end. And she started to investigate Islam. When she heard about the unseen, that Muslims believe in the jinns, and when she read about stuff describing the jinns and describing the shaitan, she knew instantly that this is who she was dealing with. So you have this industry, and it's a very corrupt industry, and this is why it's very important that the Muslims, we should stay away from that.